right now. This is the Chris Newman Podcast, Season 1, Episode 1. I'm really excited about this. Pretty much what we're about to do here, we're going to get straight into it. I bring special guests in, and when I say special, I mean people really special to me, special to the city, special to the community. And we're just going to shoot the shit. Like, I've really tried to go over in my head a million different ways that I want to do this podcast. And honestly, I'm sick of fucking being stressed out about it, and we're just going to go with the fucking flow. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce myself. I am Mouthpiece of the Southeast, Voice of the Ville, Man of the Hour, your best friend, your boy, your wingman. I'm VA though, man. That's why we're all here, right? Pretty much. Yeah, that's right. Round of fucking applause. I'm here to get my journalism on. I feel like, you know, I'm funny, I'm good at rapping, I'm a sex god. Those things are dope, but people don't know that I really know how to interview people and engage people. I'm kind of going for like a Howard Stern kind of thing, just that type of situation where I can get dope people in here and we can just show you how dope everything is. Big shouts to Doman Network. Big shout outs to Vintage Magazine, Vinegar Hill Magazine. I mean, big shout outs to them. Shouts to my man Deucey. Shouts to my man Sarad. Let's get straight to this. My guest for the first episode of this, very special guest, very prestigious. If I could think of a way to introduce this guy. Yeah, yeah, that's really the first thing that comes to mind.
Yeah.
Where do I start? I mean, comedian. I mean, actor. I mean, just socialite. Like, overall, natural born entertainer. I've had the pleasure of knowing this dude for most of my life. We grew up together. We've been getting it in together. We did radio together. We hosted concerts together. I'm talking about my good friend, Eric Jones, ladies and gentlemen.
E. Jones in the building.
E. Jones in the building, man. Radio personality, comedian, actor.
All that.
Where does it end, my man?
It don't end, baby. You know, not for us, like we was talking about. You know,
yeah.
I'm just glad to be a part, you know, of the show and bring my little expertise, as they say.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, just my whole vibe, and it's so crazy that, you know, the universe has worked its way out.
Exactly.
And, and we're here together. I know everybody's looking like, what is going on?
Right, right.
Like, E. Jones and Doe?
That's how we started off, bro.
Shit.
We jumped this shit off with some unpredictable things, and that's the beauty of it. Like, go ahead, get them out, man. That's the beauty of this, man. I wanted my first episode to be very solid, very organic. I feel like that's the word, the theme of today's episode, being organic and, just being true to self, man. And I wanted somebody that actually has the personality, the depth, and the professionalism to, take it to the next level. That's how I want to start this off, man.
You know what I mean? So that's what I'm here for, man. You know what I mean? So I appreciate you hitting me up and wanting me to come on and,
Yeah,
I'm ready, bet. You know what I mean? Chris Newman Podcast. Let's make it pop.
Funny story is, I tried to offer him a job. Like, yo, my nigga. Oh. So look, you start this Sunday, bro. I'm gonna be paying you once everything. Like, bro, whoa. I got my own shit going on, bro.
I got my own shit going on.
I will come spread some love in the joint. But you're gonna have to.
nah, I won't like that, man. I show love. I mean, we our situation is crazy.
Yeah.
I was, I don't want to go too in deep, but everyone always asks, what happened with radio? What happened with radio?
Yeah.
What question? I always want to ask you this. Now we're on the podcast. We're going to answer those serious questions.
Oh, we're getting to it.
We
drink my Red Bull.
What question or answer did you have when people said, why did you take his job? Because me and you both know you didn't really take my job.
Right.
We all know that, but what the fuck did you say?
So we just going to get the people
what they want. Oh, we going to get the people what they want. This 2 years. We can talk about shit like this because... It's 2 years now.
All right. So when we do things like this, I want to fill in the blanks. I don't want to just jump into it because everybody might not know really what's going on.
Right, yeah.
So we both worked for the same radio station. And, it was a dope opportunity. It was a dope situation, and for real, I've gotten a lot of experience and memories that I'll never forget from doing radio.
Definitely.
And it was rocky. It was a rocky situation because we weren't getting, you know, Charlamagne the God checks, but we was putting in Charlamagne the God work. Facts. I personally feel Facts. Like even though I know I would fuck up every once in a while.
But we expected Mr. Fuck Up to fuck up.
It was expected fuck ups. And, you know, but I would put my all into that shit, man. Yeah. And, you know, it was hard balancing, doing radio, living my life, working at 9 to 5, and making time for everything. And perfecting my own craft, putting my own music out. I was getting weird very thin. And I think I was just at the end of my rope where I was just, you know, about to be done with the shit. And, you know, you was doing the mornings, I was doing the evenings, and, you know, just a scenario came about where, you know, it was like either I'm about to be done with this or something's about to change.
Gotcha.
So, from my end, right, this is, you know, big brother situation, somebody that, you know, I was looking to, you know, to give me, you know, the the guidance and shit like that. And you know, he just pretty much, you know, I don't ask questions when niggas, if you got an issue with Dope Man, and you come to me and you say, yo, Dope Man, I don't want to know the gist of it. I know how you feel about him. That's how y'all feel. I know not to try to do business with both of y'all at the same time. You still my nigga, he still my nigga. So when he came to me like, yeah, morning done, you want it, I'm like, what, wait, what? That's how it went. The mornings is done. That's over. It's over. What do you want to do? And I'm like, yo, give me some time to think about
it. Like,
yo, bro, I got that shit down pat. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, it was pretty much like, well, what do I want to do? You know what I'm saying? And it was like, it was pretty much a situation where it was like, all right, Chris, move it or lose it. And I knew that even though I still wasn't about to get a goddamn dime. I knew that. I knew that. But I knew that I was about to elevate. And that was really the main thing on my mind. And within that, I never really took into play everything else that came into play. That's what comes with not asking questions. Am I right? Like, when you don't ask questions, it's a lot you don't know. And you've made decisions and you don't know how things is going. So when it happened, all I heard, days in, days out. What happened to Kitty? What happened to Eric? What happened to Kitty? What happened to Eric? Why'd you do this to them?
And I'm like, I know you was like,
bro,
I didn't do anything.
But take the job. That's
and you
literally
had to, you know, and I told you that.
You know what I'm saying? And you know, it was one of them situations where you're like, hey man, hey, don't say it, nigga. What?
Hey yo, funny story though. So the nigga hit me, right? The nigga was, I'm talking about Dope Man too.
Yeah, right.
The nigga hit me, right? And he was like, yo, alright, so what you do? <I'm> like, what are you talking about? I ain't do nothing, bro. So I told him that blase, what happened, whatever.
Right.
And I was like, alright, so don't take the job. He was like, you right. I ain't gonna take the job.
Right.
So we hung up. I said, this nigga gonna take the job. This nigga, hey look, I wake up the next morning, the nigga on the joint like, yeah man, big ups to E. Jones, man. This nigga about to get an Oscar. I was like, this nigga right here. I knew this nigga was gonna take the job. But I knew he had to take it because it was the right thing to do. And I told you, I would have did the same thing.
Right.
You know what I mean? You had to, there was no purpose of not taking it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Even if it was malice intent. So I just want you to know that I never had malice intent with you.
Right.
You know what I mean?
So
just to clear the air.
There was
everything that anybody ever said.
To keep it a buck, there was some guilt on my part. I remember running into you and your wife, and I would be drunk. And I would just pretty much be like, oh,
like, yo, I'm sorry, man.
I'm sorry. And you're like, yo, bro, relax, yo. I'm like, dude, y'all still love me? Like, yeah, bro, we cool. Like, you sure? Okay, all right, I'm gonna go now.
Yeah,
like,
man.
Literally,
it was all good, though.
That's how, and that came from the people being like,
I always just wanted to know.
Because they want to know what I did to y'all to get to take this run. And I'm like, bro, it really won't like that. And you know, big shout outs to the big homie, man.
Yeah, big shout outs. You know what I mean?
You know what?
We 2 years past that. You know what I mean? So definitely, you know.
You know what? I got a lot. Like I said, I got a lot of experience and I got a lot of courage from doing radio day in, day out. And honestly, it's an experience that I couldn't recreate from anything. You know what I mean? So that's a beautiful thing, man. So
yeah,
that's where I think after, you know, us graduating and stuff, I think that was our point where we both met each other there at radio. You know what I'm saying? And you know, that won't end for us, man. You actually kept it going, man. The acting. So let's talk about it.
Oh, man. I mean, you know, I was supposed to have my BMF hat on now.
Yeah.
BMF, we getting back to that 50 Cent. You know what it is, man.
Yeah.
Audition about to start back up in Detroit, I think LA, whenever the corona, you know, stop. And
right. So just to bring it forward, you auditioned for the BMF biopic.
Yes, biopic.
Okay.
Slash miniseries that's gonna be on Stars.
Okay.
Showtime.
Okay.
Slash, you know, well,
okay.
Stars.
Okay. Okay.
It's been a year, so those are the preliminaries of the audition phase.
Yeah.
Now they're gonna go back to the script is already written now. They've already got the budget.
Yeah.
So now it's about the casting part, and they're gonna. I'm pretty sure they're gonna recast some people back. So I'm just hoping I'm a part of that. But in the meantime, I am on tour with a couple other plays that was about to take off, about to hit DC,
course.
Texas, and now it's COVID. But
without
soon
all
as
of,
that,
as
soon as that's done, I'll be back on tour.
And the most recent one,
Rapper's Delight.
Rapper's Delight, and that's by written by my homegirl, man,
Fran Harris.
I love her, yo. Let me tell you, I love her, yo. I had a situation where she kind of tried to pave a little situation for me. And, you know, I went for it, you know what I'm saying? And it wound up not working out, you know what I'm saying? I was so mad about it, right? That, like, I could tell, because we were talking, she was talking about the play when she came to me, pretty much what it was, I was gonna be doing like hosting the UVA games, right? So to have that opportunity, any dude that's grown up in Charlottesville his whole life thinking I'm gonna be in the middle of that stage, like in our line of business, come on, I was like, sign me up, and I was like, this is either gonna go really great or really bad. So I auditioned, right? Murdered it. Killed it. Dudes was, oh my gosh, you're so good. Right. You know. It's show business,
BS,
you know.
BS,
right. So I'm like, man, this is my first time really doing this. I've never auditioned for anything. I just go. You know what I'm saying? I auditioned for the joint. And I'm like, wow, they're really happy, right? I'm like, we'll call you. I'm like, all right. Well, you got a week or I'm going to call you. So the week went by. I called. Hey, y'all, it's me calling again. So I'm like, yo, I guess I ain't get it. Of course I didn't get it. Why would it take so long for me to hear back from them? From them telling me, oh, in a week, you know about it. And it's been 3 weeks. I already know. So they pretty much was like, politics, whatever. I ain't get the gig, right? So I was so crushed by it. I just.
How long ago was this?
This was probably right before y'all started auditions.
Damn.
This was right before. And I knew that after that, she knew how heartbroken. Because I told her how bad I wanted this.
Yeah.
And I was just so crushed by it. Like, she was like, yo, call me, yo. We can figure something out. Man, look back to the. You know, I get in my. You know,
she's
plugged
in though, man. She's plugged in, bro. So just bro, stay, you know.
Definitely, my man. Shout out to my man Papers. He linked me up with her.
Yeah.
Honestly, man, good people.
Good people. Papers is
real good people, man. And you know, I kind of wish I'd have. Kind of took the L a little more maturely. I took it. That's how I was. I took the L like, what? Oh, no. I quit everything. Like, that's really how it was. Because if, you know, you the type of person, so when I saw that Rapper's Delight was coming to play, and I saw that you was a part of it, that was the first moment where I, like, snapped out of it and was like, I probably should have just took it. You know what I'm saying? I should have just kept moving instead of, like, you know what I'm saying? And it's so crazy, like you said, how the universe worked, that you happen to be my first, you know, actual guest here.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
I think that's a dope thing, man. So,
hopefully a fixture.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but
so give us, it's for the people that, you know, it's like, we ain't going to see no play, motherfucker.
Yeah. Hey, bro. It's so hard. Talk to us. I mean, it's just so hard transferring the urban community, our people, as we say, over to theater. Mm-hmm. Now, when I first started, was down at Jefferson Theater and did a lot of August Wilson plays. They're very long. You know, us black people, our attention span is very minute.
Right.
So it's like, after about a good 30, 45 minutes, we like, all right, we ready to go. The game about to come on. So how long we got?
You know what?
45 more minutes.
You know a dude that's been in the theater to say that motherfuckers is very minute.
Yeah, I mean, you know, you have to be a theater head.
Right.
But it's good play. I mean, what's happening now, what Fran is doing is a la Tyler Perry. Is the same format that he's used, and when you come, the plays aren't that long, but they're full of comedic timing and funny parts and moments that you can gravitate to. So when you come see her plays, that's why I love doing work with her. And not nothing against Jeff, because I started down there. That's what made me. That's what got me on, you know, Seville Weeklies and things like that. So I definitely pay homage to the Jefferson Theater. I mean, not Jefferson Theater, but the Jefferson School, African Heritage School. But what Fran is doing, man, is pretty dope, man.
Yeah.
And
it feels more home
working
with her as opposed to...
To me, the only reason, and a lot of actors that do theater is if you can do theater, you can do anything.
Right.
As far as acting.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because theater, there's no cut.
Right.
There's no. Once you hit the stage, if you don't know it, it's just like a rapper.
Yeah.
You get up on stage, you know what you want. So, you know what I mean? Right now, I'm ready to take it, and I feel like what I've built and what she's building too is something moving forward a la Tyler Perry with his shows on the road and building up mass people to come out and enjoy themselves. So, I feel in the next 2 years, you know, she's going to be the pinnacle of
See that. I can definitely see that. So. Definitely with the cast that I saw that she put together.
Oh yeah.
Big shout outs to you know, my other characters, man. I really was looking forward to getting to see you up there. I missed you in your first joint. I think I seen it maybe online a couple times, but it was refreshing to see you in that lane. Because to know you is to know that you're a natural entertainer. We was talking about it earlier we're both funny motherfuckers.
Funny
motherfuckers. Right? But like...
you know what I called you.
No, say it. Go ahead.
I mean, me and Chris, we're both funny.
Right.
But I'm a good funny. This motherfucker's a bad funny. He's Dennis the Menace. He'll rub you the wrong fucking way to the point... like, I might want to fight this nigga. Whereas me, I might rub you, but you like, that's just E.
Right.
That's like, my nigga, you know. Whatever,
I can live
whatever.
With it.
I can live with it. I'll go to sleep.
Right.
With this nigga, you going to sleep thinking about it, like cocking the nine, like, how you thinking weird shit? Did he fuck your baby mom? No, he didn't fuck my baby mom. What are you talking about? You know what I mean? So, it still gets the same approach and the same delivery, but it's just, it's a different approach on how we attack it, which, you know.
Right. So when I see you attack different crafts, I'm saying all that to say, when I see you attack different crafts, it definitely is an inspiration to me, because nothing makes, you know, it's different. Some people start hating, some people do different things, but with me, nothing inspires me more than seeing somebody do something that I wish I did. That's what gets me going. That's what made me a good rapper. That's what made me a funny dude. That's what made me, you know what I'm saying, an entertainer. I'm looking for the dude that's making me feel like, I wish I thought of that. You know what I'm saying? There's nothing, as an entertainer, as a creative, there's nothing more blissful than to see somebody do something and it's like, yeah, okay, okay. And I'll never forget, shouts to my man LT. He had did the, yeah, big shouts to him. He did the joint for Irv Gotti in Richmond.
A lot of backlash for that, man.
Right.
A lot of backlash for
right,
that.
But, right. Now, then why would there have been backlash?
I mean, you know, a lot of people was upset about why you got to pay. I mean, you know, I've been doing auditions for a while now.
Uh-huh.
I really don't pay for auditions.
Right.
So, my whole thing was, I don't give a fuck.
Right.
I'm getting my name out there.
Right.
So, granted, every actor that got on stage was not better than me.
Right.
But that's what's going to happen sometimes.
Yeah.
And you got to live with, we was talking about that, you know, don't, you know, take that no and keep it moving.
Right.
Whereas in that lane, it was like, okay, I spent $150, but I got my name out there to some producers that
right.
might bypass Irv. You know what I mean? Okay. He might not be necessarily what I'm looking, but okay. I got my name out there.
Okay.
But a lot of people didn't see it that way. They was looking like a bunch of y'all going up there wasting y'all money and... Mm. And I didn't really look at it that way.
There's a very thin line between this shit. Because I got a lot of homies that pay that fucking bread to open up for Yo Gotti. I got a lot of homies that pay that fucking bread to open up for the baby. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of bros that put that bread up to go to South by Southwest. You know what I'm saying? Me, personally... Fuck that. I'm not paying y'all shit. Alright? Okay. You motherfuckers should pay me by the time I'm done out here. But that still limits me as to me getting my name across. But here's the deal with a lot of those situations. It's up to you, the creative, to know, alright, is this really gonna benefit my career? Hmm. Is this really gonna benefit? Or can I take this 150 and do something that could really benefit? Because it's like, if not... You're being exploited.
Exactly.
Your thirst and your want is being exploited. There's a cause for all of it. There's some dude at the top that knows how bad you want it. It's some dude that ain't even at the top. He's on the shoulder of another nigga that's at the top, but he the closest to the top. Exactly. Niggas like us gonna get, you know what I'm saying? Just running into at a fucking Walmart. You feel me? We see the nigga, he dripped out, da-da-da-da-da. He's telling you, boom, yeah, throw me 250. I get you on stage with the baby. I'm going to have a whole bunch of A&Rs there. Who wouldn't take that fucking opportunity, right? Like, the average dude that wants it and says he wants it, a lot of them got money to back that shit up. You know what I'm saying? Like, before, in my day, and yes, I'm saying it to make me sound that old. In my day, if you had the skill, if you had the flow, if you had the overall, you know what I'm saying?
Cachet.
Yeah, if you had that shit, that's what pushed that's you to go. Nowadays, if you got that bag, somebody in your camp like, bro, why don't you just start rapping? Why the fuck don't I just start rapping? You know what I'm saying? And that nigga's like, what? 250 to open for the baby? Nigga, I got more money than the baby. And the promoter's like, yeah, nigga, sure you do. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just so, it's a very thin line. It's really up to you, the creative, to say, is this worth it? Now, I wouldn't have known nothing about it if it wasn't on live, right? And LT's phone wasn't the only phone in that motherfucker. Nah, I saw phones all over that bitch. And I watched so much of that goddamn thing. Like, if you feel like at any time that audition shit was, you know, lingering and the shit is taking forever, nigga, I was feeling your pain because I'm like, all right, let's wrap this up. Yeah, who the fuck won? Like, this is hours now. So if you think about it, every head that came in that motherfucker and dropped a couple chains, nigga, Irv Gotti back on top, nigga, it's murder.
I mean, yeah, you know what I mean? I looked at it as, okay, my whole thing is, I was heading to Atlanta anyway.
Right.
So this is just my portfolio.
Right, right.
This is strictly to build it. So I'm already taking this shit down there. So you already telling me, my dude, what you saying is, all right, fuck it. Y'all might not make this shit, you know what I'm saying? But you ain't gotta worry about me. Mm. You can go in there and bypass me and talk to my producer. That's what I was gonna do anyway, nigga. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm thinking. I'm already 10 steps ahead of the game because I know in this entertainment, the buck don't stop with you.
Right.
So I believe in me that much, that 150, I'm like, all right.
Let's do it.
I'm investing in me.
Yeah.
Because I've never invested in me.
And there that goes.
So right now, it's like, fuck it, let's invest.
Let's do it.
You know what I mean? So that's where I was at. Yeah. Everyone else has their own thing on how they did it. I can't really say why most cats got up there and did what they did knowing you ain't that damn good.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, why would you spend that money? But hey, tease your own, man.
You know something? I guess the whole point of that is to go to the fact that I was fortunate enough to catch your audition. And nigga, I was moved. I'm not gonna lie, I was fucking moved. And you wanna know why I was moved? It wasn't the material. I don't even know if it was the accuracy and how good you were up there. I don't think that was what impressed me the most. I think it was the fact that you went up there, you did not hesitate, and you took what you wanted. And that was everybody's fucking attention in that motherfucking room. Whether you walked out with that W or not, you knew that in that moment you could hear a fucking pin drop because everybody was going to be just as into your performance as you put into that performance. I could tell the whole... Nigga, I was quiet at home. Like, I'm at home watching and I'm thinking to myself, like, damn, he's killing that shit. But I'm like, nah, let me be quiet. Because
let me tell you a funny story, though. So the whole night I'm contemplating. I'm seeing Doe, I'm seeing Raj, I'm seeing everybody. I'm like, getting up there, they rapping, they gangster. Everybody getting up there with their gangster monologues.
Right.
So I'm sitting up and I'm like, all right, I don't really want to be cliche. I don't want to do Denzel. You know what I'm saying? Because Denzel is like the pinnacle. You get judged in so many different layers.
Yeah.
And sometimes you can be just as good as him, but they like you, not him. So I didn't want to tell Denzel. And I didn't want to do... I was going to do a part from Rozelle joint, but then I was like, nah, everybody doing it, so I'm going to do a Slay.
Yeah.
So what's my best part that I've ever did that I captivated people and made them cry?
Okay.
So that's what I did.
Okay.
It was left field.
I really knew
I was taking a chance when I did it because I lost.
Right.
So that's what I knew when but I felt good walking out that motherfucker.
Right.
Bro. I felt really good.
Right.
And it's funny you say that because... I knew once I left stage, everybody was looking like, and then they just start clapping like, what the fuck just happened?
What just happened?
Because no one expected a nigga come up there talking about some slave shit.
Listen to me.
Nobody.
Let me
them
walk.
Them niggas was looking, them niggas was like, what the fuck is going on here? I was looking at Doug, Doug was like, what the fuck is going on? I seen Book. Book stopped me traveling. And nigga was like, yo, I seen you, yo. You killed that shit. I was like, oh shit, like,
bruh, alright, let me just walk you through it from my home, right? So I'm watching, right, and I'm like, oh, E. Jones about to get up there and do something special for him. Like, motherfuckers don't even know what he about to do right now. I didn't even know it was a fucking competition. I had no idea what I was watching. I learned about that shit that day. Just in case anybody was like, why you ain't up there? That was my first fucking day learning about the shit. I've been looking at the flyer every fucking day never thought what the fuck it was, bruh. It's so many flyers. What the fuck? Yeah. You know, like, I'm coming off the dawn of Annex and shit like that. Flyers upon flyers. All I know is Irv Gotti's in town. I don't give a fuck. All right. Anyway, so I'm watching you and you started off and I was like, oh yeah, this nigga's smart. See, because it's very risky to not be cliche. In the day and age we are in today, it is very risky to not be cliche. It's very risky to not do what everybody expects you to do, because it could be a nigga that been faking it till he making it, and that nigga's gonna make, he's gonna tune right past you because he knows cliche shit is what they want. He knows that all I gotta do is lose just a little bit of integrity for myself and do fucking training day. You know what I'm saying? No, nigga, I don't have range. Apparently, I'm doing training day. You feel what I'm saying? But Y'all just want some regular niggas to come up here and do some regular nigga shit to impress a bunch of other regular niggas so this can be better than Power. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, this motherfucker's brave. So as I'm watching you, you're like, I told you, I was gonna get out of here. You can hear a pin drop. Everyone's in awe, bruh. Every person on that fucking phone, every person in that fucking room, Irv Gotti himself, even if he asked himself, what the fuck
just happened,
he's captivated. You did your job. That $150 was worth it.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's what I knew, because all I heard, good job, Eric. Good job, Eric. I was like, okay, yeah. You know, and another thing on that. So, I went to that just 8-9 months later. I was just at the BMF.
Right.
So they asked for all our Instagrams and everything.
Right.
So I'm dipped in BMF. I'm all that. So, I mean, it could be a cliche, but hey, they might have looked at that too.
Right.
But everything, I knew what I was doing when I did it. That's 50 shit. That's 50 shit. So I knew what I was doing when I did it.
Yeah.
I have no, you know what I mean, things with neither one of those guys. I'm just trying to get it.
That's like I go get jumped in by the Crips and they go check my Insta and they see 2 weeks earlier I just got jumped in by the Bloods. Who the fuck is wrong with this nigga? Like, honestly, bro, I wouldn't even think that would be, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, them niggas will probably try to snatch you up before, you know what I'm saying? I don't think Urban shit. I see you doing way more than that. I see you doing some shit to have a whole motherfucking room crying like a bitch, because you got, and you know, bro, I'm a hater like a motherfucker, bro. I try to find as much negative shit about people I can think of, bro. But when you do what you do, and it's undeniable, those are the people in the world that get the most respect from me. You know what I'm saying? You, Dough Man. You know what I mean? 700 quails some motherfucking times. But like, I respect niggas that is undeniable. Like, you take it to another level. Jamie Foxx type shit, where the nigga's funny, but don't let that shit fool you. It's other layers to this situation. So I think that's a dope thing.
And before you, I don't want to segue into it, you know, I don't want to get put in a box.
Right.
So much time as an actor or as a comedian or whatever, you get put in a box. Okay, you're funny. That's where you're going to stay.
Right.
Nah, bro. I want to have layers. I want to, you know, maneuver. So, you know, that's basically what I'm heading on.
So,
you know.
So what's next for Eric Jones?
Podcast, man. You know, podcast. I mean, like I told you right now, I'm skits. I got some crazy, crazy ideas. I was talking to Dough Man about it a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
But definitely, man, I'm ready to light the internet up, man.
Yeah.
And so I said, we definitely gotta figure some things out, and that's the next step for me. Until we can get back, till we got people in the seats, people in the movie theaters, then the acting thing is on hold.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? I mean, I am going to be auditioning for some voiceovers.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Because that's where the money at. You know what I mean? The money's in the cartoons, whatever.
Yeah.
But right now, podcast, man. Yep. You know, podcasting. You know,
just Eric Jones podcast coming soon, man.
Well, I don't know if it's gonna be Just something.
It's so, like we talked about.
I'm gonna
this
be
before.
Dealing with a podcast. You're gonna see me on podcasts.
Right. Because I mean, like I said, it's so many different ways to do this.
Yeah.
It's so million. I could literally just have a webcam in my room and I just rant for 40 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's some motherfuckers that just do that shit. So, you know, this is really dope. So, amidst COVID-19 and the quarantine, and you know, you being a traveling actor, I know that must be a hectic situation for you. You know what I mean? But I know you staying sharp with it, man. I ain't worried about that at all. But how are you? And you know, you got a TikTok. You got
I kind of backed off, bro, because everybody's on the top now. So
yeah,
I'm like,
top.
I ain't really trying to tick with them. I'm gonna let them top. I ain't trying to tick with them. So I'm like,
I've seen you do videos with
your
family.
Yeah, you know, and then it was just a wave coming, and I'm like,
Definitely saw you doing videos with your family before families were doing videos with their family.
So and let me tell you how our minds work together. So when you put up that meme, That video that I had about with the girl, I had already had that in my bag.
Oh yeah.
For about a week and a half.
Okay.
So the way our minds be thinking, it was so crazy. So we had put it up and it went viral. I was like, I can't put mine up now. You know what I'm saying? I can't put mine up now.
That's what,
you know,
it's what all saying? About. Doing but something to make the next nigga say, God damn it.
You know what I mean? I gotta hit it. But you know what I mean?
Fuck.
That was, you know, that was pretty dope, man. But definitely, man, I hope this is definitely not gonna be the last time I'm on here, man.
Yeah, definitely.
I'm gonna be fucking with you. You know what I mean?
Good, man.
It got a little serious, this one, but we all know we both are not.
Right.
About, so this is the first episode, so
yeah,
you know.
Definitely. I want this shit, to be informative.
Okay.
But I want it to be normal. I don't want a motherfucker to feel like, oh, this nigga trying to be funny. No, my nigga, I'm just naturally fucking funny. Like, I'm talking to a naturally funny guy. This shit is like some fucking, you know, Larry David shit, man. Like, you know what I mean? Fucking 60 minutes out this motherfucker, man. Like, it's just beautiful because we have no rules, bro. And we get to do this shit the way we want to do this shit in the manner we want to do this shit. And I think it's going to be a dope thing, man.
How does that feel? I know this is Chris Newman, but I just got to ask you, I'm proud of you too. You know what I mean?
Thank you.
That you actually are doing it.
Right.
Because everyone that knows you have... How can I politely put this?
Lightly put it.
You have a hard time of really pushing forward. Like,
once a
stumbling block comes, all right, fuck it.
All right, yeah.
You know what
got
I mean?
You.
Instead of just
failure,
you know what I'm saying?
Failure,
you know,
to launch.
So to
is what
see
we call
you
it.
Actually
yes. doing it, yes, yes.
With no thought process, just I'm gonna do it. That shit is therapeutic, bro.
Yeah.
So I just want to say that and keep you know, I'm gonna be around to push you to make sure this shit keeps going too.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Definitely.
Even if I'm a call or whatever, because I believe in you.
I believe this
whole ordeal is a calling. You know what I mean? You know, we're not.
And we're going to work the kinks out. It'll work itself out. You know, I just feel like just come up here. That's it. Organic, man.
Organic.
I want it to feel like a natural situation, man. It's a lot of niggas out here that try too hard, man. And sometimes less is more. And I'm super unorganized any fucking way. So this shit just going to turn out how it turn out.
Facts.
This, what you're looking at, this, none of this is was in my vision. It just turned out that way. That's pretty much how that shit works, man. So yeah, man. House of Vinegar Hill. I actually was on the cover of one of these. I couldn't find one on the way here.
How the hell you not know how to cover of you on and you don't have it on the first?
Well,
I digress.
This is the most recent joint. Shout outs to anybody that wants to do any type of fucking, I mean, all these fashion designers in the city. Big shout outs to the good people at Dr. Bronner's. This is lavender organic hand sanitizer. You
good
can find
stuff.
It at your local Whole Foods. It's locally made. It smells delicious. And it's just fighting that COVID right off your hands, man.
And you it's expensive.
It's very expensive. It's not cheap at all. Big shout out to my man, Doman. Doman Network. Y'all can't see right now, but he's wearing the Pepto-Bismol line.
Ooh, he's feeling a little sickly.
Yeah, he's got the...
He's sick with it. He's sick with
y'all
it.
Y'all can't see his
His
salmon.
His
joggers.
Salmon with his claws on.
Big shout out to him. Something weird happened to me on the way here today. Well, I caught a lift.
Okay.
Because Doman was super late. So I caught a lift here.
We're not even gonna get on that.
I had the sack on me, right?
Okay.
It was a nice healthy sack. And I left, put the joint in the bag with the Vinegar Hill stuff. And I hop
no
out
pun intended.
It was in the bag. So I hop out the lift, right? I leave the bag in the lift, right?
Oh.
So the dude's like, hey Chris, hey bro, yo, you forgot something. So I come back, I get the joint. We up here, I'm chilling about the room. I'm like, yo.
What?
My sack a little light. And you know what? Yeah, he definitely hit me. But he could've just kept it moving. It's hard times, man. COVID-19, bro. For real, I would've gave it to him as a tip anyway, you know. But yeah, that's what happened to me today.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how's the love life?
It's going pretty good, man. I'm actually decided to not post any pictures.
I heard you say that. I didn't know if it was serious.
No, I'm dead serious because, you know, as long as I know she's pretty and we happy, I'm good. I did that before. I did that in a relationship before. And I don't see how the fuck... How the fuck do people post pictures with a person and be like, oh, we forever. Then it doesn't work out, right? And then there's someone else in like less than 3 months, bro. I can go down the same time. Like, how the fuck do y'all do that? I haven't posted a picture with a female in 4 years, bro. And I'm terrified to go through all that again. Like, I just... Forget it. And then, if we break up, nobody knew it existed anyway. No harm, no foul.
Okay.
You know?
I can dig it. I can dig it. I just wanted to ask. I just wanted to test
your
pulse.
Nah, it's good.
I just wanted to test your pulse. That's
fine. Good. Everything's good. Everything's good with you.
Everything's good. You know what I mean? Family's good. Daughter's good. You know, she's pissed that school's not going on, but you know, it is what it is, you know?
How old is she now?
She's 15, man.
15
She's driving, too.
Driving?
Driving my whip, bro.
Driving before
Driving my whip, and ain't even telling me, bro.
She's just taking a whip?
Nah, they going on a little, you know, because she's about to take the test soon.
Okay.
So they been, you know.
Yeah.
And I get a little upset.
Yeah.
Mostly because I'm not a part of it.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Out.
Yeah.
This mommy time. You know what I mean? Mommy daughter time. You probably a little too tense. You know what I mean?
I'm very tense.
Need her to relax when she's behind the wheel, bro.
Yeah, she can't deal with me.
Yeah.
I'm like, no, stop, motherfucker. No, not See? Get the not get you know, yeah. so yeah, you right. You right. Yeah. It is what it is. Yeah. But yeah, they doing good, man. You know, just getting ready to, you know, do what they need to do while I do what I do.
Okay.
And you know. But yeah, man, everything's good. How mom's on good?
Yeah, my mom's.
She should be chewing you out on your stands on social media, man.
Yeah, you know,
stay getting chewed out by everybody.
You know what? See, man, but see, my mom knows that she's the one person that like, all right, I'ma chill out. Like I'm gonna calm down. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And you know, I need that sometimes. But and you know one thing, my mother never just jumps on random posts. If I'm being outlandish, she'll step in and say Facts. Something. You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, she's not like, oh, look at my handsome son when I post a profile pic. Like, she's not annoying like that. So I haven't blocked her yet is what I'm getting at. You know what I'm saying? So when she does say something, it's like, all right, man, whatever. You know, I stress her out, but whatever, man. Yeah, man, so... you want to plug the play? I mean, I know you can't do it.
Right, it's like we were supposed to go on tour last month starting, but we should be back to things normal going into the fall. So it's Rapid Delight, the play, .com. You can look on Eventbrite.
Gotcha.
Yeah, you know.
Okay.
Smoke it.
It's all good.
But Eventbrite, you can get your tickets on there. Moving forward, they're gonna be added dates for different cities and things like that. So yeah, keep on lookout. You know, I'm gonna plug it. You know, I'm gonna be plugging it away and stuff
That's
like
what
that,
it
man.
Is, man. All right. So season 1, episode 1, Chris Newman Show, VA Doe, Eric Jones, my man Doe Man with the Salmon Joggers.
Salomon.
Shout outs to him.
Salomon, not Salomon. Salomon.
Salomon the God. Shout outs to him.
God.
And yeah, man, until we can actually get here on time and do this shit again.
Ah, yeah, on time. Shots fired again, man.
Bye-bye.